Now, the embattled governor of Kiambu County, William Kabogo, says he has no apologies to make over the alleged hate speech remarks which have caused such a storm in Kenya. But as the governor remained defiant, the opposition party court has cried foul, saying none of their members was accused of making hate speech remarks. He was arrested within hours, whereas Kabogo is still a free man.
The embattled Kiambu Governor William Kabogo has this to say to all Kenyans demanding an apology from him over alleged hate speech.
Who am I apologizing to? I spoke in Kikuyu to those who were in the Kiwanja. If they do demand apology from me, who am I to say no? I will tell them, what am I apologizing first? That people are youthful and they need to behave? You know, people want to insinuate other things that we have not said. Don't put words in my mouth.
While attending a function in honor of a popular Kikuyu vernacular musician, John Ng'ang'a, alias John DiMathew, over a fortnight ago, Kiambu County Governor William Kabogo made remarks which allegedly bordered on hate speech. On Monday, Kabogo recorded a statement with the police after the video containing his remarks was aired widely through social media. Kabogo's utterances that targeted the opposition seemed to imply uncircumcised men are childish and lack leadership skills. Officials from the ODM party Nairobi branch say Kabogo's utterances were unfortunate, irresponsible and uncalled for.
A whole governor in a cosmopolitan county like Kiambu, is he trying to tell us that all those uncircumcised people in Kiambu County who voted for him should vacate? Yeah. Are we not supposed to be fearful that he might actually sponsor forceful circumcision or eviction of people that he perceives not to be circumcised? Where does leadership come and how is leadership related to circumcision?
NARC Kenya leader Martha Karua also weighed in on hate speech and accused the government of applying double standards.
As citizens, we must not keep quiet as our nation slides towards the cliff. The time to act is now.
Do we have a different justice system for court-affiliated persons and a different justice system for those who are affiliated to the Jubilee administration? Now, that is what is called incitement.
The Council of Islamic Preachers of Kenya says hate mongers must be stopped now lest they push the country to anarchy.
Tusingoje mpaka tupelekwe ICC. Tusingoje huko. Hapa tuna mahakama, tuna polisi, wachukue majukumu yao. Wanayajua adhabu gani inastahili inajulikana.
But Kabogo remains defiant amid the backlash.
Ila drama ya vita, sisi hatuna haja na vita nitarudia. Lakini pia uko chocho. Yuko?
So we are calling upon none other than the president, Uhuru Kenyatta, of this nation to come forward and put a stop. Tell his generals to stop inciting Kenyans.
We are therefore calling upon the executive, one, to apply the law equally to all without fear or favor.
ODM Nairobi branch argues Kabogo's utterances on male circumcision are not only dangerous in a country that is battling tribalism, but targeted the many communities that do not practice some cultures.
We are now getting to the issue of culture. The only other thing is that you are next going to get into the issue of religion. Of course, ethnicity you have already pounded enough. So when one circumcised person turns against an uncircumcised person, or the uncircumcised starts hitting the other one, where are we leading? Where are we heading as a nation?
Patrick Amimo, KTN News.